Hello, this is Harry Norman for Proactive Investors and welcome to another Proactive Audio interview. Today is the 13th of January 2010 and I'm talking with Hans Rasmussen, President, Chief Operating Officer and Director of Eaglecrest Explorations, listed on the TSX Venture Exchange, Metals and Mining Sector. Stock ticker EEL, share price 54 cents Canadian, market cap $20.25 million Canadian, web address eaglecrestexplorations.com. Hans, thank you for joining us for this interview.
Thanks for having me.
Why is a geophysicist and geologist such as yourself looking for gold in Bolivia and Colombia?
Well, I've been in the business for 26 years now, and most of my time has been spent in the Americas, and I feel very comfortable. I'm almost bilingual, and the potential for discovery is going to be in places that have been looked at the least. Two countries that represent that would be Bolivia and Colombia. There are others in South America, but these are two places I feel very comfortable working in. Have high potential for discovery, particularly if you look at the history of production of metals. Both of them have 500 years of history of metal production, so that's why I like those places.
What progress has been made at Eaglecrest Explorations' San Simon Gold Project in northeastern Bolivia, and what ideas do you have about how this project could be commercialized?
I've been involved with Eaglecrest since January 2007, and we've made some very significant progress in understanding how gold is distributed in the known zones of gold mineralization. That was huge. That was a big turnaround for the company in terms of actually coming closer to a resource calculation. And we were producing gold at the same time as we were drilling one of these zones at the project. So two things have come together that lead to what we would end up commercializing. Number one is we can find more gold because we know where it is, how it's located, how to drill it. And number two, we know how to produce it. We know that it has great metallurgy. 85 to 95% of the gold can be recovered because we had a gold processing plant working for almost 2 years, and we were producing a gold concentrate from the rock that we were pulling from the underground. So commercialization, from my point of view, is selling the asset to a producer. Our goal at Eaglecrest is to be an explorer, to drill out gold resources, to pave the way for a producer to come in and buy the asset and go into production. We've only had time in my 3-year term with Eaglecrest so far to work on less than 20% of the property. And within that 20% of the property, I feel like we have very strong indications we can have 3 different areas with economic gold mineralization. Of course, to prove that, we've got to drill, and that's the next step for Eaglecrest.
What are your thoughts on operating a mining exploration and development company in Bolivia, Hans?
Going back to the places in the world where there are producers operating, Bolivia is one of those places that producers are operating in very good communications with Coeur d'Alene, who put the San Bartolome mine into production. And if you look at their news release last November, I think it was, or December, they comment how the government was very supportive, and they're making silver at about $6 an ounce, so highly profitable in a historic district with lots of headaches. You know, where you've got lots of people to deal with, they were able to go into production, and the government was very supportive. The same for some of the other big projects that happened in Bolivia. You looked at the San Cristobal project, where Apex Silver put that into production with the help of Sumitomo. Now Sumitomo is mining there. The new one that's going into production is called Mutun, and that's an East Indian company will invest $2.1 billion to mine half of the iron ore deposit there. So it's a pro-mining culture. I think that the mining operations and developments are possible in Bolivia. You just have to have a good relationship with the government, like in any Latin American country, and move it forward.
What can you tell investors about your recent acquisition, Fredonia, in the Central Cordillera Gold Belt of Colombia?
The board of directors of Eaglecrest decided that Colombia was a great place to diversify Eaglecrest in terms of having multiple exploration properties and diversifying in this fantastic gold market that we're coming into. Colombia historically has been the largest gold producer in South America, so that was geologically a great place to think about. And just in the last 5 years, 6 years, let's say, the stability and safety of the company has become significantly better than it was even in the late 1990s. So we decided, okay, this is the place to explore, and then Fredonia was selected because it's close to infrastructure, and in and around the Fredonia area, you've got some resources that have been drilled out that are about 2 million ounces, and you've got a couple of historic districts with well over 10 million ounces of both historic production and ounces of gold that sit in the ground. So that area, for me, was a large real estate play in terms of getting our foot in the door in Colombia, grabbing 18,000 hectares, or 180 square kilometers, of mineral title in an area that's highly prospective.
What are your thoughts on operating in Colombia, Hans?
My understanding is right now of Colombia, it is a very co-development culture. Of course, we get some examples now of people operating there that will go into production in the near future, like Anglo-American or Anglo-Gold Ashanti at the 12 million ounce La Colosa project, and then up at the La Mascota Ventana Gold project. You've got some new drill results, and that's kind of the hot topic on the street right now. Those guys are going to be going into production in the next 5 years, and from what I understand, they've got great relationships with the government, and the government is pro-development. So from what I can tell, gold mining is part of their culture, and the law of the mining laws is upheld in court. So there's no question about whether or not you're going to be able to mine. It's just you've got to follow the steps in order to achieve the mining permits and things like that along the way.
Eaglecrest Explorations has just closed a non-brokered private placement raising nearly $580,000. Where does this leave the company's financial situation going forward, Hans?
Well, at this stage, we have a burn rate with our Bolivian operation and our Colombian operation of about $150,000 a month. So if you just do the math on that, you're looking at about 3 months burn in that financing. We opened and closed that financing really quickly because we had an interested investor that was an institutional investor that we wanted to get into Eaglecrest right away. So that was open and closed before Christmas, and something that's very difficult to do. Literally, the meeting with that investor was somewhere around December 11th, and thing was closed 14 days later. So that was a very small place compared to what we were seeking, but we basically wanted to open and close it for that particular investor. We're going to continue to look for more financing. We're going to need about $4 million a year in terms of total burn if we want to start drilling in Bolivia. And once we start drilling in Colombia, then we're going to have to bump that up even higher.
When did Sprott Asset Management become investors in Eaglecrest Explorations, and has their investment encouraged other institutions to take an interest in the company?
Yes, Sprott Asset Management is the lead on this $580,000 place that we just closed. And again, they were interested in getting involved with Eaglecrest. They met management, and they liked the idea of both Bolivia and Colombia and gold. To date, we've basically gotten through the paperwork of the placement and not had a chance to spend much time marketing the fact that Sprott is in. So we haven't had a chance to see if their investment will encourage other institutions. Now, on that same note, in 2007, Doug Casey personally and his hedge fund and a couple of his employees invested in Eaglecrest just based on the tour of our Bolivian operation. And so we've had institutional investors, and that really helps the story. Doug, of course, you know, word of mouth, I'm sure, helped get other investors in that bought shares in the market. We're hoping to use Sprott Asset Management for both shares in the market and to encourage his friends and connections to get involved in terms of more financings for Eaglecrest in the future.
What can investors expect from Eaglecrest Explorations over the next 12 to 18 months, Hans?
That's a great question and great time frame. We're going to basically move forward aggressively with Colombia, looking at multiple new projects to add that will kind of fill in gap in the new Fredonia block we've signed on Colombia. We're going to hire a person that will be our vice president of exploration to move that program forward aggressively. That basically starts with basic geology, geophysics, and then eventually drilling in Colombia, say, after mid-year. The Bolivian operation is totally dependent on investors. We're waiting for enough funding to start drilling. At this time, we're trenching. We've got a staff of four Bolivian geologists, and then one gringo senior person that's kind of the VP of exploration on the project doing trenching, mapping, and preparing for drilling once we get the financing. So basically, you could expect in the next 12 to 18 months, once we get enough funding, we can drill immediately in Bolivia. We'll be drilling after mid-year in Colombia. In Bolivia, we can have resource calculations by the end of the year on possibly two of our three selected target areas, one being underground and two of those being open pit style resources. So we're really ready to move forward aggressively. It's just the last year and a half, funding has been the thing that's controlled the rate of moving forward with any company. We feel really strong about the project. We've had a chance to do a lot of basic geologic work in Bolivia, and we feel very strong about our new acquisitions in Colombia.
Remember, Proactive Investors is not an investment advice service. Make sure you register at proactiveinvestors.com or proactiveinvestors.co.uk for our weekly newsletter, which will keep you informed about our articles, interviews, and events. Thank you for listening.